Can we talk about mukbangs for a second?
Yes,
and how dangerous
can.
They are.
Oh, God damn, Rose. Yes. That's a, that brings
I'll be,
us into
I'll be part of the problem.
I mean, you be the pusher. It comes from your culture, Rose. God damn.
God damn. I know. My culture be crazy as hell. So if you guys don't know, I'll just give you a little rundown in case you don't watch YouTube and in case you're not familiar with mukbang videos. Mukbang is a Korean word. It stands for eating show or eating broadcast. And that's exactly what it is. It's literally people filming themselves eating and
food,
broadcasting
it.
Yes, usually a lot of food and broadcasting it to an audience. Now, and it started in Korea and everyone thought it was the weirdest fucking thing. And then it became a trend all over the world. And I like to do mukbang videos.
Yeah.
I have Mondays on my channel.
Yeah, I have a question. Just as a side note about mukbang. So what do they call the mukbang stars in Korea?
I know you know the answer to this one, Daniel. So they are called broadcast junkies, also known as BJs.
Yes.
Oh, God. Sometimes I wish I could be like a consultant for, you know, everyone in Korea that doesn't speak English. So I could just be like, you might not want to call it that because it means something else in English. But,
exactly.
You know. Yeah, so, but that happened.
So the big mukbangers in Korea are called BJ stars.
BJ stars, yes.
Yeah, nice. Nice.
I know, right? They do like to put things in their mouth.
I mean, oh gosh.
So
that's the background of like mukbanging, right?
Yes. And the problem is, I try to be a responsible mukbanger, even though it probably doesn't get as many views, definitely. Yeah. But I tried not to eat an extortionate amount of food. Although, you know, I do have a strong appetite. So I do like to have, you know, I do tend to eat more than the average person.
Yeah.
But I try not to have way too much food in front of me. And I definitely don't overeat to the point where I'm going to, you know, like I'm uncomfortable. I always eat until I want to stop. And I do try to add in healthier mukbang videos, and I try not to do junk food all the time. And I also don't do mukbang videos every single day. So those are the ways that I try to make it so that I am being a bit more responsible. But I think I need to even put a disclaimer on now, because I was talking about this with Angela, my roommate, and this is an actual like
problem.
It's a health crisis. It is a problem. Have you seen what these people eat?
Yeah, I have. It's ridiculous. Like, it's to the point where it's like so extreme. And then because I was thinking about this the other day, because I was watching certain mukbangers. And I was like watching, and I was like, oh, well, maybe they, space out their recordings. But it's like actually every second day they're eating these massive.
Every day. Yeah.
And it's like crazy. And I'm thinking, imagine if they do like, you know how we do bulk recording of this podcast? I wonder if they bulk record the mukbangs.
Oh my God. Can you imagine?
Could you imagine like them eating like fucking, because it would be like McDonald's, for example, but it would be like
it's
their
so
whole
disgusting.
Table. Is full of like 27 burgers and like chicken nuggets and everything. And then the next thing is like Popeyes with like cheese sauce and like all this crazy. And I'm like, imagine they bulk recorded that shit.
Oh my God. And you know what? Someone commented this on one of my mukbang videos, and she said, she made a very good point, or she or he, I'm not sure, but she said, you know, it's funny that, basically she said it's problematic that, you know, when a relatively thin individual like an average size individual films a mukbang video eating like unhealthy food or lots of food, then it's like praised and, you know, looked on as something to be aspiring to, or like, you know, it's not criticized. But then if someone that's fat is doing that, then it's criticized.
Yeah.
Whereas it's still the same unhealthy food. It's still doing fucking bad things to our bodies. So a lot of these mukbangers are actually very skinny, and I don't know how the fuck they are, but they're very skinny. Some
Especially
of them are very
the
skinny.
Shit that they eat. I'm like, how?
I know. But that doesn't mean that they're healthy, you know?
No,
that's
exactly.
The thing. So they're still promoting very unhealthy, you know, eating on their videos.
Yeah.
So I think that should be something that we should be calling them out on, because a lot of them don't get any flack for it. And they're eating like 20 burgers in one sitting. And I'm like, so if that person was fat, they would get a lot of flack, you know?
I think the thing is too, and we talked about this, and this links back to talking about, again, YouTubers like oversharing and all this kind of stuff. And there is a strong link. And we saw this in like a very famous documentary. Do you remember Super Size Me back in the like 2000s, early 2000s, I think it was, about eating McDonald's every single day for like 30 days. Now, I'm not saying this is what the mukbangers do, but if
you're worse, they do worse.
Exactly. If you're eating that amount of junk food, like some of these channels are insane, and you're eating this amount of junk food every day or almost every other day, this disgusting amount of junk food,
it's
going to have an impact on your emotional state, right? Because the guy, it's like that guy from Super Size Me. He would like eat a huge McDonald's meal, and as he's eating it, because of the drugs or whatever that's in the food, he would like get this like massive high, and he was feeling so great and like, ooh, I'm loving this like Big Mac and blah, 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 blah. And then the second he was like done the meal, he would like slip into this like almost like a depression where he was sad. He felt like he was going to throw up, all of this stuff. And it's like, these people are doing these crazy mukbangs with even extreme amounts of food. So it's not going to be good for your mental well-being either.
Yeah.
Like it is a big problem. Like
100%. It's such a big problem. Yeah. You're right about the Super Size Me. Like I remember that guy, he was like depressed when he was like not eating, and then he would eat and instantly he felt, you know,
better,
like high. Yeah, you're right. Like he was getting like a high.
Exactly.
And because, you know, he's getting all that sugar and all that processed stuff that's designed to make you feel good. But then afterwards you crash and you feel like shit. And yeah, I can imagine that if you eat that way every single day, and like none of these people are eating healthy shit, they're always eating like junk food. And not to mention a fuck ton of animal products, which fucking disgust me too. Like,
exactly.
Anyways. And then even if they don't eat at all, like, what the fuck is the point? You know,
exactly.
It's such a waste.
But I think that this is where I think, like, because, like, I know you do mukbangs on Mondays and stuff, but usually your mukbangs, like, I've watched some of them, and, like, they're not, like, as extreme as other mukbangs. It's, like, more
and
of
I
a
And I try
kind
not
of,
to be.
Exactly. And it's more of a, like, you know, not as...
Just yummy food.
Exactly. It's just eating yummy food, talking about the food that you're eating and everything else. But, like, these extreme mukbangers, it's too much, you know what I mean? And again, it comes back to the whole like mental state of some of these people. Like I just think you're eating these extreme amount of bad food for you, and you're gonna have all these like mood swings and all this like crazy stuff. You see them having breakdowns on their channels, and the sad thing is we as society justify this behavior by clicking and watching these videos. So,
but like, you know, it's not just a matter of, you know, it's bad for their health, which it is. And I don't know why anyone would, I just don't understand why people would choose to damage their health in the long run just for, you know, YouTube clout and YouTube gain. I honestly just can't understand. Even when I do, cause like I do once a week mukbangs, even when I do like two unhealthy mukbangs in like a month, I'm like, okay, maybe I should just dial it back and stop. Like, you know what I mean?
Exactly. Yeah.
But then it's like these people do it every single day, and like that is so damaging. And then they're putting it out there without a disclaimer, without saying, hi guys, it's not healthy to be eating this much food in one sitting. Like disclaimer, like I feel like there should be some kind of regulation, like saying, okay, maybe we need to be protected. The viewer needs to be protected. And like, I know it seems obvious, but to a lot of people, you know, they might need that fucking reminder, you know, like the cup is hot. What is the thing where, you know, you have to put a disclaimer, like extreme caution, hot cup. It's like, yeah, it's fucking obvious, but like it still needs to be there.
And me and you, where we're talking about this now, and probably a lot of our listeners as well, would say, yeah, okay, that's obvious. But we have to remember that young kids are watching this, really impressionable young kids. And so that's why the disclaimers need to be on there. And that's why, but I do think in general, like, well, not in general, there still needs to be a long way to go, because this whole idea of like social media and everything else is still new to like businesses, to like corporations and all this kind of stuff. And I think they're starting to do like now, if it's an ad on Instagram and stuff, they have to like kind of, they're starting to say hashtag ad,
there's more
hashtag,
regulation. Yeah,
exactly. So it's starting to come into place, but I do agree with certain videos and content. And I actually think going back to the whole idea of like mental breakdowns and these people going crazy on camera, maybe there should be little disclaimers on those as well. You know what I mean? About, you know, no, but like, honestly, like, you know, this is, I don't know what disclaimer they would put on there. Like, do not act like this. But like, I don't know. There needs to be something just because it's just not really like, I don't know.
And then they see, the thing is, they also see that a lot of, not everyone, but a lot of these mukbangers, like I said, are skinny. A lot of them are attractive. And then they see this attractive skinny person eating, you know, 50 million calories in one sitting and they think, oh, wow, you know, like that person's eating that much. It can't be that bad for you because, again, we have a misconception that if you're skinny and you're eating healthy. Bad food, you're healthy, which it's not true at all. Exactly. There's a lot of unhealthy skinny people. So, and again, I think I mentioned this in the previous mukbang, in the previous podcast we recorded, but like these people are still very young. They're like 20 years old. Mm. They're going to develop these bad eating habits. They're going to eat this stuff every single day. And then what in 10 years, in 20 years, when their health starts to catch up to them, what the fuck are they going to get? Are they going to do? Exactly. You can't buy your health.
Exactly. And also they have to remember that there's a lot of stuff going on under the surface of our bodies that, you know, they might on the physical, we might look great and be like, oh, I'm really slim, whatever else. But like your arteries, there's lots of other stuff that's going on underneath the surface where it's like, if you're not taking care of your body properly, like you might be in look in shape, but your inside of your body could be like a rotten, horrible mess. You know what I mean? Like it just could be,
oh God. Yeah.
Not in a good place. So yeah. Crazy.
So that's the mukbang rant.